November to January, then suffered some bad losses in February. It made for a ticklish selection Monday. They were on the bubble.
Big time. And really what ended up playing out well for them was their wins came against teams that ended up either being in their conference final or actually won their conference. So that helped their RPI.
That's a shot clock violation here for the Bonnies, so they give it up. They lost to VCU in the A-10 quarterfinals a couple weeks ago, so it's been a while since they've played. They've gotten behind here early to Oklahoma State, but he's got a team that can score a lot of points quickly. Jensen, again, well defended. Here comes St. Bonaventure. Amani Outlaw, backup point guard from Cincinnati. She's number 22. They work it inside to Katie Healy. Goes to the other side of the rim and gets the roll.
Excellent finish there by Healy. And it's really the first time the Bonnies have been able to show that versatility from their post players.
And another empty possession for Oklahoma State as they give it away. Healy attacks. She's got a great first step. And one, Katie Healy, the senior from Lancaster, New York.
This is where Healy can really take advantage of her speed. She just is able to get around Jensen, and then we're going to see in a second from the top of the key, just that quick first step, like you said. Again, with that reverse layup, uses her body well. And she just does a really good job, I think, of realizing where her advantage lies and using it. And early, Oklahoma State has really shuffled in some post players trying to figure out, you know, how Coach Littell's going to nullify that. And finally, Healy's figured it out.
Well, the Cowgirls had an 8-point lead at one point. It's been cut to two with under 4 minutes to go here in the opening quarter. Jim Littell showing some concern, but he always has a concerned look on his face, to be honest. Brittany Martin, that baseline jumper doesn't go. Mariah Ruff will push the tempo. Three-pointer on the way, and it's good, and the Bonnies have the lead as Drummond knocks it down.
None of this is surprising to me. The way the Bonnies play, they're looking at the long game. They're not worried about what happens in the first couple minutes. They're just sticking to their guns, sticking to their scout and their schemes, and letting it play out.
In under a minute, an 8-0 run for the Bonnies. Martin falling back. And she has yet to find her rhythm. Skip pass. Ruff for Healy. An extra pass. Baseline jumper goes in. That's Matea Brickbar, the sophomore from Orlando, getting on the scoreboard.
This five-out style that the Bonnies are playing, we're starting to see where Oklahoma State's going to struggle.
Martin with the right hand. No. And Martin now 1-for-4 from the field. She went for the steal, didn't get it away from Healy. Another three on the way. That one draws iron. Healy is going to be called for a foul over the back. That's her first.
St. Bonaventure foul, number 42. Katie Healy.
I think with the Bonnies, what they're able to do is dribble, penetrate, kick. And right there, it's just a simple play of drawing the defender, kicking to your teammate for the three. And to Drummond's credit, she knocked that one down. And she really has been the steady Eddie so far for St. Bonaventure. Got those two layups early and then followed up with that three.
She's got 7 points. She's on the bench right now for the Bonnies. They got so many interchangeable parts.
They really do. It makes them very difficult to guard.
And now Martin is fouled. If that's on Healy, that'll be her second. No, it's going to be on Ruff.
St. Bonaventure foul number two, Mariah Ruff. That's her second.
Her second as well, so.
15.
Richmond and Ruff both with two personals.
Ruff's that player that might not look that athletic, and that's out of Jim Crowley's mouth, but is one of their defensive stoppers, and she's the type of player that he knew immediately. Once they drew Oklahoma State, I was putting Ruff on Martin. And even though she gives up some size and unfortunately got in that foul trouble, you could see she was forcing Martin
Joseph
to take tough
Coleman
shots.
Check in for Oklahoma State.
Another free throw coming for Brittany Martin. Last player on the roster recruited by the late Kurt Butke. First Oklahoma State player ever from the state of Utah. What a career she has had in Stillwater. Not one of two. And the Bonnies leading by a deuce. The 10 seed leading the 7 seed right now. Winner of this game gets Oregon State on Sunday. everybody getting a touch. One too many passes, and then Coleman got a hand in the passing lane. Andy Coleman, a long reach. She's 6'3". They find Coleman. Double team, stripped by Healy. And now she's in free flight. Katie Healy lays it in.
That was a great example of what St. Bonaventure wants to do on defense. Causing that turnover was just simply playing in the gaps.
St. Bonaventure traveled 2,600 miles to get here, so far that their charter flight had to stop in Bismarck, North Dakota for fuel. You know that after a long trip like that, they were going to give it everything they had. It's not going to bounce. It's going to stay on this end with six on the shot clock.
Emily Michael in for St. Bonaventure.
Troy, who we saw earlier today, they lost to Oregon State. They also traveled a long way from the state of Alabama, but the body's coming well over 2,600 miles. Miami, the furthest trip in this year's women's NCAA tournament. That's picked off. Reeder with the steal. She tried to thread a pass to Drummond. It's kicked out of bounds with a minute, 1 second to go here in the quarter.
So far this quarter, to me, has been St. Bonaventure's.
You bet.
They've really established. You can tell what their game plan is and what they're trying to do. Play the gaps on defense, move the ball, and use their mismatches on offense.
School from Western New York, about an hour south of Buffalo. A traveling call, so the Bonnies will cough it up here. A minute to go. Third smallest enrollment in Division I basketball, St. Bonaventure. Just over 2,000 students. So this is a school that takes a lot of pride in their programs, especially when they make it to the national stage.
Of course, and for the women, this is only the second time, but obviously their men's team has a rich history.
Now they were left out of the men's tournament this year. They were on the bubble too, didn't get in. Under 10 on the shot clock, Martin dumping it down. Jensen double team, she traveled. And that's another Cowgirls turnover.
Great job by St. Bonaventure. They're obviously giving up a lot of size inside, but what you see is just a very disciplined brand of defense. They're not going to go for shot fakes. They're not going to go for steals. They're not going to go for blocks. They're just going to play you straight up and allow their teammates to help.
The Bonnies are going to hold for the last shot here. A 1 second differential between game and shot clock here in the first quarter. Drummond to Reeder. Four to shoot. Got the shot off and it goes down for Healy. What a quarter for her. St. Bonaventure with a 19-point first quarter, and Healy scores eight of them. The 10 seed leading the 7 seed after one here in Corvallis. Katie Healy, the senior for St. Bonaventure, so excited about the way this game is going for the Bonnies that she just lost track of time, Sue.
Well, I think you're right. I think when you score 10 points in a quarter, you think it's halftime.
She ran off the floor at the end of the first quarter, came back to the huddle. As you can see, where's Katie going? And you can read her lips when she comes back to the group. I thought it was halftime.
I'm sure she's going to love that this is on TV. I wish I could have been there in that moment where she got in the locker room, turned back, didn't see anybody, was like, oh, wait a minute.
Oh, that's a beautiful moment. Already in double figures. Couple of rebounds, an assist. Katie Healy, the best players ever to come out of Western New York. And their Bonnies are leading 19-13. We're underway here in the second quarter in this 10-7 matchup. First round of the women's NCAA tournament. Winner gets Oregon State on Sunday. Oregon State rolled over Troy in the first round here earlier today. They go inside. And Latasha Jones was denied in there. And St. Bonaventure has defended the paint just the way they wanted to so far. Three, Nyla Reeder got it.
That's the
top three-point shooter.
That's the type of player that feeds off hitting that first shot. She has some high highs, some low lows, but that first shot is extremely important for her.
Timeout, Oklahoma State. The senior from Indiana knocking down another triple, and the Bonnies with a 22-13 lead. Jim Littell's Cowgirls, the 7th seed, down 9 to St. Bonaventure. The last 2 years, Oklahoma State has faced Florida Gulf Coast in the first round. Last year, they got beat. And Sue, the Bonnies, unconventional, much like Florida Gulf Coast, and it's given the Cowgirls trouble again this year.
Yeah, poor Coach Littell. It's really the one situation. Again, we have an offensive foul here.
Oklahoma State foul
on a screen, but it's really the one scenario that he dreads, having to play against these unconventional teams with these styles he hasn't seen much all year. And really, he's a team with a lot of size, as you can see, and yet having to guard, even with Healy, basically guards.
Yeah.
And that's not easy.
Now, Healy is their tallest player. They list her at 6'1". She's probably closer to 6'3". See, they are red hot. 7 of their last 9 from the field. Reeder. Bounce it to Healy. In the short corner, she drives to the paint. Kicks it to Brigbar. She knocks it down from just beyond the free throw line. She's got 4 points. It's 24-13. It's a double-digit lead now for St. Bonaventure. And Oklahoma State in a scoring drive. Walton, Jensen. They are not making it easy for Jensen to find room to operate in there. There'll be a foul on Miranda. Check that, Matea Britvar, her first.
That's what St. Bonaventure is going to give up. That kind of double-teamed, not clean look. You got to figure out a way to make it, and definitely got to figure out a way to make your free throws.
Yeah, she's 0 for 3 at the line now. NCAA Wrestling Championships continuing tonight for Madison Square Garden. Catch the semifinals 8 Eastern. ESPN. Watch ESPN. Anti-mat coverage on ESPN3. Oklahoma State, a great wrestling tradition, 34 national titles. The women's basketball team in trouble here, down 11 to St. Bonaventure in the first half. Healy. Dribbles out of trouble. Healy again with 5 on the shot clock. That's a jump ball. It's going to stay with St. Bonaventure. Just 5 on the shot clock here for the Bonnies. One of 3 teams from the A-10 to make the field. Draws iron for Reeder. George Washington and Duquesne, the other teams from the Atlantic 10 who got in. Seattle, which finished in that three-way tie, or St. Louis, excuse me, which finished in that three-way tie for first in the league, the team that had to settle for the women's NIT.
The A-10 is a very difficult conference. It had a very high RPI rating, and the teams, basically, those top four just kind of went at it all the way to the end.
Drummond doesn't get it to go. Long rebound, Martin. Had it taken away, got it back. And now she's tied up by Drummond. Lost the Cowgirls. But
right.
St. Bonaventure is contesting everything.
They've done a great job. And Nyla Reeder right there saved a layup. And if you're Martin, you have to understand what St. Bonaventure is trying to do. They're not going to let you get in the paint. So when you have the opportunities in transition, you gotta be more aggressive. I think she should have gone way more aggressively to the rim on that one.
We've only seen Martin take 4 shots so far in this game. She's 1 of 4. They've got to get her lathered up. If she gets hot, that could change everything.
It could, but she's a mid-range player, and the Bonnies don't let you get there.
Holman for 3. And she got it. A little help from the rim. Not a bad 3-point shooter, 30% on the year. Very athletic big.
She is. She's the type of big that can handle the ball, shoot the rock. That's important for Oklahoma State. And she's not scared to shoot it.
Yeah, and she could be the X factor. They need a third option today, but Katie Healy needs to be stopped first.
Katie Healy is just killing Oklahoma State's bigs. They're putting her on the perimeter and letting her just shot fake and go at them. And early in the game, Oklahoma State was using different lineups, putting different players on Healy, quicker players, and I think they might need to go back to that look.
Foul on Britvar, that's her 2nd.
Again, Healy just has an incredibly quick first step, and I don't think people expect it necessarily. And all you're going to see here is a situation where she goes boop right by him and gets that layup. And she's so long. She really doesn't need to get that close to the rim. Her arm kind of does the work.
Nice move by Martin, the floater in the lane, and she gets the roll.
That's
that might get her going.
That's important, but again, it's that mid-range, and they were able to get her there on that out-of-bounds play, but they need to find a way in the half court as well.
And Reeder was fouled driving to the hoop. Do you think that Brittany Martin is going to be drafted next month in the WNBA?
I do. I think it'll be a question mark, a big question mark, where in the draft order, probably more of a second-round player. And what I find amazing about the NCAA tournament is it could make or break you. And right now, we talk. She's kind of unknown. So these are big games for her and her future. It's not to put pressure on her or anything, but it could help her stock a ton if she can showcase her talents in this NCAA tournament.
An All-American Big 12 Player of the Year, Defensive Player of the Year in the Big 12. Led the league in essentially every meaningful statistic.
The fact that she's so versatile in terms of what she brings and all the categories she can fill up on that stat sheet, that's where she could really set herself apart in terms of the draft and the WNBA and where she fits.
A game left for her to showcase, yeah. 10-point lead for St. Bonaventure after the two makes by Reeder at the line. There's the floater again from Martin, drew the front lip.
That's okay, that's her shot. It seems like a weird kind of funky fadeaway, but that's her shot.
She's developed that over the course of this season. She's done a lot of work in the gym this year. It's a strong shot by Richmond. Backside rebound, here come the Cowgirls. Carly Wheeler into the game for the first time, the freshman from Plainview, Texas. And that's a foul on the Bonnies. Drummond with her first. Third team foul on St. Bonaventure. 5:31 to go here in the half. Sydney Walton to trigger. And in for Gentry Holt. That's a foul on the floor.
St. Bonaventure foul number 14, Gabby Richmond,
third. That's a third on Gabby Richmond.
Katie Healy in the lineup for the Bonnies.
So she's going to come out of the game for St. Bonaventure. Again, the first big off the bench all season for Jim Crowley, so it's a big foul. Bonnies with the ball, leading by 10. Surprised by this score right now?
I'm actually not. I think, this tournament's all about matchups, and this is just a really tough matchup for Oklahoma State.
Maycock traveled. And Oklahoma State will get it back. Oklahoma State picked eighth in the Big 12 preseason, finished fourth. They had some great wins this year, including the only win against the Baylor Bears. Baylor has one loss, and it came to Oklahoma State. That was in late December, start of the Big 12 campaign. Baylor, of course, the number one seed in this regional, the Dallas Regional. They won today over Idaho. That's not going to count, but Martin was fouled.
St. Bonaventure foul, number 32, Miranda.
That was a great cut by Martin, and really what you've seen from her all game, and definitely keep your eye on it. She does a great job of receiving down screens and tight curling, and that's how she usually gets her mid-range game going on that one. Because the Bonnies know she's trying to do that, she hit him with a little backdoor cut and was able to get to the free throw line the unconventional way in the bonus.
Talking about that Baylor win for Oklahoma State, Nia Johnson did not play in that game, but, you know, Oklahoma State was terrific from start to finish. It might not have made a difference. By the way, Nia Johnson today against Idaho, 16 assists. I mean, she is outstanding.
She is, and really what impresses me most about her is she's not necessarily a scorer. So usually when you're a scorer and you're kind of drawing attention, the assists open up that way. She clearly just has a knack for finding the open player, getting people the ball in places where they can score.
Bonnies have cooled off now. They're one of their last five from the field. They still have an 8-point lead, under 5 minutes to go first half. They tried to feed it into Healy, and then she was fouled from behind on Martin.
Oklahoma State foul, Brittany Martin.
Oklahoma State kind of taking a page out of their earlier book and putting Martin on Healy, a more active, quicker player.
Turnover.
I think that's where the key lies for Oklahoma State. You know, kind of letting the other players beat you and taking one of your best defenders and putting it on their best player, even though it's a different position. Brittany Martin's a guard, Healy's a forward, but I think you got to ride with that.
Chance to cut into that lead a little more here for the Cowgirls. Martin, the skip pass across. Coleman again for three. Tipped out by Martin. No reset. Wheeler finds Walton. Her three goes down.
Sydney
Walton having a great first half. She's got 8 points and a couple of threes.
Tremendous first half. It's really going to open things up if she can continue to be a threat out there.
We cut to five of the Cowgirls. That goes in from three for Emily Michael, the senior point guard. Not a big score, but that's a huge three-point basket.
It seems like St. Bonaventure answers. They answer the call every time Oklahoma State does something positive. Boom, they hit a three. Boom, they get a basket.
Grad student from Clayton, Ohio. There are five grad students on this Bonaventure team. St. Bonaventure, the most grad student players in Division I. And it's going to belong to Oklahoma State here with 3:27, excuse me, to St. Bonaventure with 3:27 to go in the half.
And with Martin on Healy, she sees that they're overloading that side and finds her teammate. You know, she can't create off the dribble. She can definitely do it with the pass.
Oklahoma State, not a great three-point shooting team. It's not what they're known for, but they're getting it done today. Brickvar misses the two, rebound Martin.
When speaking about styles, that's basically what I meant. Oklahoma State is going against a team that forces you to shoot outside shots, and that's not their strength.
St. Bonaventure is going to get it on the possession arrow with 2:54 to go here in the half. Bonnie shooting 52% from the field.
All off driving kicks, all off creating closeout situations and scramble situations, and they're getting really good looks because of it.
Thrown up, doesn't go for makeup.
This is where I think Oklahoma State has to attack, in transition.
And Coleman was fouled when she went into the paint.
Smart move by Coleman, though. And this is a player, again, we talked about it. A four player with guard skills can handle the ball. If they're not going to get good looks in their half court sets, then when they do get stops and they do force missed shots, they need to push it.
So Mandy Coleman's going to go to the line. That was the third personal on Brickvar. Her and Richmond each with three for St. Bonaventure. The NCAA Men's Basketball Championship continues tonight on CBS, TBS, TNT, and True TV. For more information on game times and listings, go to NCAA.com. Bonnie's with the lead. Katie Healy, a great first half. She's got a dozen. Maycock will give it to Healy. They pass so well. Bob Knight would love this offense. It's constant motion. And that's a bad pass. Michael couldn't click with Healy. And Bonnie's turnover. And that's her seventh.
Yeah, I mean, you never want to see foul trouble for one of your best players, but Jensen on the bench right now with two might have been the best thing that happened to Oklahoma State because it could put Martin onto Healy. And since, St. Bonaventure has struggled.
Wheeler for three. She's been up and down this year, but the freshman with her first basket, and now all of a sudden the game is a four-point difference.
She can shoot. She can definitely shoot. She just, as you said, has been really inconsistent with it.
She had 19 at Texas Tech, 10 at Kansas. Do that kind of stuff on the road. And certainly going to show promise, which she has. Healy, jumper. Got it.
Wow. It's that weird one-arm, a little bit unorthodox shot, and she's able to get it off. And is efficient with it.
Back to 6-14 for Katie Healy, the senior from Lancaster, New York. Coleman, and that's going to be a foul on Healy. She can't believe it, and that's going to be her second.
Healy knows that in order for this team to go, she's going to have to get it going. And right there, you can see her. She wants to get Martin in the post. She steps out, which has been really good for her. Sizes up the player and hits the jumper.
St. Bonaventure, what they have done to shut down Jensen, to keep Martin in check, the most impressive thing in this game. The offense, yes, but the defense is probably what's going to win this game for St. Bonaventure.
Absolutely. I think one definitely affects the other, and for the Bonnies, what they've been able to do defensively has given them a little confidence, gotten them going. They were able to run a little bit early on. And that's why they have this lead. But it is a small lead, so Oklahoma State's figured it out a little bit.
Coleman at the line now. She got five. 33-28. We're under a minute to go here until halftime. The 10-seed St. Bonaventure leading the 7-seed Oklahoma State. Point guard Emily Michael, the senior from Clayton, Ohio, very patient on this possession. Healy with five on the shot clock, skips it across. Here's Michael. Penetrates, one to shoot, and they aren't going to get a shot off. That's a mistake we haven't seen St. Bonaventure make really in this first half.
No, but Oklahoma State, again, has done a great job of switching up their matchups. They're switching it up, and they're actually giving the Bonnies a little taste of their own medicine. They're packing it in. They're saying, beat us from the outside. You've been able to dribble drive all day. Beat us from the outside.
Jim Crowley, a big proponent of that pack line defense.
I am too.
Hey, look at what Tony Bennett's doing there. Yeah. Look at Virginia on the men's side.
With certain teams, I think it's the way to go.
A 4-second difference, game shot clock. Great rebound by Coleman, but right into the hands of Michael. And she traveled with 1.9 seconds to go here before the half. Oklahoma State will have it. Stay tuned. Northwestern Mutual halftime report. Kevin, Kara, Rebecca in studio for scores and highlights. South Carolina and Jacksonville, 1 versus 16. South Carolina, one of the teams that maybe can upset UConn in this tournament. Martin counts if it goes, but it doesn't. And what a half for St. Bonaventure. A small school from Western New York, led by Katie Healy in that first half. 14 points, 3 rebounds.
She can run off the court now. It is halftime.
There's Jim Crowley, the 10 seed leading the 7 seed at the half. We now send it to the Northwestern Mutual halftime report and Kevin Nagandi.
Northwestern Mutual halftime report. Kevin Nagani in studio with Kara Lawson and Rebecca Lobo. We're at the half in a couple games.
And I think they made a tremendous adjustment in putting Jensen on the bench. This is a player that usually provides a lot of low post scoring. She wasn't scoring, and she was a defensive liability. So it worked out.
Healy was terrific in the first half for St. Bonaventure. She actually thought it was halftime a little early. She came back for that second quarter and was terrific. 14 points in the first 20 minutes.
Yeah, she really did it all. Here you see her in transition, earlier blowing by Jensen. She also has a nice little outside shot, so she can step out and hit that. And for Oklahoma State, thank God they hit some threes, because that's the only thing keeping them in this game. And they hit a few, and they're really not known for that.
No.
So again, they should be very thankful those things dropped.
Let's take a look at the first half stats. And you can see that St. Bonaventure shot it well, 52%. From the field, Oklahoma State out of their comfort zone, but doing well from 3, 5 of 8. Turnovers about even. The points in the paint, surprisingly led by St. Bonaventure, the smaller team. But again, you mentioned Kaylee Jensen, who spent a lot of time on the bench in that first half, a 6'4 sophomore from Nebraska. She was out of the game so much in the first half, St. Bonaventure was able to go in and take advantage of it. She has 2 fouls. She starts the second half for Oklahoma State. See if we can get her on track, as I'm sure what Jim Littell is thinking as they feed her right away. But then a jump ball, possession to St. Bonaventure as again Jensen is defended perfectly.
They've just done an excellent job of pushing her out, making her catch it a little bit further out than she'd like, and then corralling. The minute she touches it, you can see people are faking at her. They're not double teaming, but they're just showing her who's around.
Jumper doesn't go for Reeder. Here come the Cowgirls again. Martin, eyes behind her head, keeps it. And now collision. Jensen goes down to the deck. That's a foul on St. Bonaventure.
With Jensen.
Jensen foul.
Right, with Jensen. Again, it's a player that really does a great job for Oklahoma State on the low block scoring. But by sitting her, Jim Littell was able to change up his matchups. And that put Brittany Martin on Katie Healy. And immediately you can see the difference. Katie Healy was not able to dribble penetrate the same way, which then kind of bogged down that Bonnie offense.
Well, she just picked up her third foul.
Blessing in disguise?
And it might be. That's going to put her on the bench early here in the third quarter. Backdoor pass and cutting was Drummond. The bounds will stay with the Bonnies. Kaylee Jensen, fourth in the Big 12 with 10 double-figure games. Martin led the Big 12 with 19. Such a great 1-2 punch. But Jensen has been non-existent offensively in this game. There's a travel and a turnover. And Martin has really been held in check. She had 8 points in the first half.
Yeah, but she had to work hard for those 8 points. And you mentioned earlier, Oklahoma State all season has been really reaching, trying to find that third, fourth option.
Yeah.
With Martin and Jensen being 1 and 2, with Jensen on the bench, that third, fourth option better show up quick.
Well, Sydney Walton for a while there in the first half.
St. Bonaventure foul number 33. Emily Michaels,
first. Walton had 8 points, a couple of threes. There she is. Then they kind of shut her down in the second quarter.
The Bonnies just play it straight up. They play very disciplined, play the gaps. They let you make the mistake.
This is Walton, the crossover, pull up. As it goes, Cowgirls rebound. Martin in a battle with Healy for it. Another jump ball. It's going to stay with Oklahoma State with 8:34 to go here, third quarter. So Jensen on the bench. They're missing her offense. She averages 15 per game. She has given them zilch. And
yeah.
She's got three fouls.
I mean, it's just a tough matchup for her. That's all it is.
Gentry Holt into the game again for the Cowgirls. Number 13 with that black headband. Martin, watched by Mariah Ruff, a very good defender. Former Miss Basketball in the state of New York. Martin bumps off of her, doesn't get the shot to go, and there's a foul underneath.
Oklahoma
goes against Oklahoma State.
Every time Brittany Martin has caught the ball in her sweet spot, which is in that mid-range area, elbow, free throw line area, she looks up, she catches, looks up, she sees her defender, and then the four others behind her. I mean, they pack it in. I can hear a fan yelling, drive it, drive it. She can't, there's nowhere to go.
Winner of this game to play Oregon State, the hometown heroes, blowing out Troy in their first round game earlier today here in Corvallis. Off the miss, Caitlin Lecker, the junior from Kansas, pulls down the rebound for the Cowgirls. Really good possession here, down five. Coleman. Didn't even draw the rim. Another jump ball. It's going to go back to the Bonnies. We have not seen a point yet here in the second half from either team. St. Bonaventure 16-0 at home this year. Struggled away from Riley Center, going 7-7. That's what was going to make today a challenge, but so far so good. Three ball. Doesn't go for Ruff. Coleman trying to run it down for the Cowgirls and does. Hits it ahead to Walton.
This is where I think Oklahoma State needs to push it. They need to take advantage of the transition.
She's hit from three once already today. Doesn't get that one, and now Ruff wants to push it for the Bonnies. Three on two. The feed to Drummond, and she finishes.
In a game where your offense is bogged down and teams aren't allowing you to do what you want, when you get stops, you gotta go. You gotta just see what can happen. I feel like, especially Oklahoma State, they need to push it and don't stop until the other team stops you. Don't stop yourself. And you see the Bonnies did it, and it worked out.
Lead is seven for the 10 seed. They post up Martin. She turns around, draws the back iron. And a foul on St. Bonaventure.
Again, St. Bonaventure, when they got the stop, they were just able to push it. This is a really good finish by Drummond. Again, early in the game, she was the one driving, finishing at the rim, hit a three, in fact, and on this last play, you saw what she's good at. She can finish.
And Drummond just picked up her third. She's the third player for St. Bonaventure with three. Oh, nice drive. Off the feed, Martin scores her first basket of the second half.
Her best looks have come from those under the basket, out of bounds plays. Somehow they need to make that happen more. I don't know how you do that, but.
She's the first player in double figures for Oklahoma State, and now Ruff is fouled.
Again, Martin's best looks have been off these out-of-bounds plays, and they do a little pick-the-picker style. She reads the defense again, bumps back, and then just slips right through. She has that ability, and at her size, once she gets in there and kind of gathers herself, it's really difficult to stop her shot.
Mariah Ruff has another foul shot coming. She misses the first. The road to the Frozen Four begins with the 2016 NCAA Hockey Selection Special. It's coming up Sunday, presented by Northwestern Mutual on ESPNU. That's going to start at noon Eastern. Get the rebound, and St. Bonaventure will work with the shot clock here, leading by five. A 1-for-7 start here in the second half from the field for the Bonnies, who were terrific from the field in the first half. Richmond. And that's an offensive foul, and that's her fourth. Gabby Richmond is going to head to the bench again.
Seems like she wasn't quite sure what to do, and that's just a great take by Lecker, you know, to beat her to the spot and plant her feet. And it's frustrating, I'm sure, for Richmond. You could see it on her face there. She's frustrated. Four fouls, she's might even played just 4 minutes.
Said that Jim Crowley has a lot of interchangeable parts, but he's got a conundrum now. He's got three players in deep foul trouble. Turnover, Oklahoma State is currently Wheeler traveled.
Yeah, the foul trouble for Coach Crawley is unfortunate because it's at the same position. It's at that post spot. And Healy with two, if she picks up another, could be even more trouble.
Rodrigo Patton checks back in for Oklahoma State.
You see it. Richmond four, Britt Barr three, Drummond three. Healy's got two. That's the player that they can ill afford to lose more than anybody.
And mainly because now two of those three were post players. Two of those three are the people that could, you know, take Healy's minutes if she did get in foul trouble, but they got their own problem in that column.
Here's Reeder. Martin took a swat at her. Good feed to Healy, and she gets by Coleman and scores.
That was just a great basketball play. They didn't have anything going, and they read the D.
First basket for Healy here in the second half. She's got 16 now, and Martin will go to the line for Oklahoma State.
St. Bonaventure is really known for playing together. Oh, wow. And all afternoon, we've seen them move the ball, pass the ball, create opportunities for each other. And right now, you just had a situation where they were able to get the switch, and Reeder read it. Healy finished it with that nice little lefty layup.
Haven't been to ESPNW.com, you need to go this week. Some great content there on the NCAA Women's Championship, including how UConn has built a great dynasty. The partner Sue Bird comments there. Also, the president's careful consideration as he filled out his bracket this year. UConn, 10 national titles, going for their 11th, all under Gino Auriemma, your former coach. And that senior class trying to make history by winning its fourth straight national championship.
It would be incredible. Think about that. you never have to deal with regret. You never have to know the feeling of ending your season as a loser. I mean, to me, you know, my senior year was, the best part about it was I could finish my college career and walk off the court and feel so great about it. Yeah. I never had the, oh, man.
Not second guessing.
Yeah, like, oh, I wish I would have done. So if Breonna Stewart and co. could pull that off, I mean, four times, but then the last one especially, that would be pretty amazing.
Brittany Martin gets both at the foul line. She's got a double-double, her 20th of the year, but why doesn't it feel like it?
So quiet, right? I think it's because, you know, her rebounds, it's one thing. I mean, she does a great job on the boards, but I think it's because her scoring has been a little sporadic. You know, she's not shooting a great percentage going 3-for-11.
Yeah, she's done most of the work at the line, 6-of-7 there. Shot clock at 5 for the Bonnies. Maycock gets it to Healy. She's got to hurry. And another shot clock violation for St. Bonaventure.
Speaking of Brittany Martin, you know, she's doing a great job on defense also. So a lot of her energy is being spent trying to stop Healy.
I've been saying that Jim Littell has needed another option besides just Martin and Kaylee Jensen. Well, we're not even seeing Kaylee Jensen in this game. Can he get a win from his Cowgirls with just Martin leading the way? Maybe. Oh, she almost got a chance at a three-point play. Instead, she'll shoot two.
That was the one time you've seen Martin get the opportunity to go one-on-one. There really wasn't much help there. It came at the very last second, but clearly not enough. And she's given up, or I should say the Bonnies, are giving up a lot of size on her in the post. And as far as that second option goes with Jensen on the bench, Walton had stepped up a little bit. Yeah. Walton's hit a couple shots. It's helped a lot.
Maycock, the foul, puts Martin on the line. Terrific foul shooter at almost 80%. Jim Littell. Trying to get the Cowgirls to their fourth Sweet 16 in program history. They got to beat St. Bonaventure first, and then whoever wins this game would run into Oregon State. Not an easy bracket to be in.
Not at all, especially on another team's home floor. Never easy.
Here's Nyla Reeder. Finger. That's her second three. She is a 40% three-point shooter. And it's 41-33, St. Bonaventure. Good defense here by Reeder. Martin. Doesn't go from the baseline.
She's got to make those. That's a good look for her. She's got to knock those in.
And winner plays Oregon State Sunday for a berth in the Sweet 16. And it might be St. Bonaventure the way they are shooting today. Reeder hits another three. Their lead goes back to double digits.
Three-point shooting is so crucial in the NCAA tournament. If you can get hot and you're a three-point shooting team, upsets happen. That's how they happen.
And we got a shot clock problem. They stop play here with 3:17 to go in the third quarter. Nyla Reeder now with 11 points. She's 3-of-4 from outside.
And for her, again, we talked about it. When she gets going early, and here it was just about using a screen. I mean, when you're guarding a shooter, Oklahoma State, that's Sidney Walton's fault. When you're guarding a shooter, you never shoot the gap on a down screen. You gotta chase. Worst cases, okay, you get beat on the curl, but two's less than three. You don't wanna give, especially someone who's knocking them down today, you don't wanna give her any open looks.
Walton goes to the bench. Oklahoma State, and now Martin goes down to the deck. That's going to be a foul on St. Bonaventure. Nyla Reeder gets called for her first. And the team fouls now to 6 for the Bonnies. That's going to put Oklahoma State on the line the rest of the way. Pardon me, 5 team fouls. Going to put Oklahoma State on the line the rest of the quarter.
That's 3 minutes. You got to just play solid D. Luckily, that's what the Bonnies are built on.
Diana Mazzi comes into the game for the first time for Oklahoma State. With Walton out, long rebound comes into the hands of Nyla Reeder. And a travel on Maycock.
What we're seeing now from the Bonnies on defense is Martin, again, on Maycock, that's a big-time size advantage. But with Healy guarding Lecker, she's just totally playing off.
Jumper from Martin over the top of Maycock.
Again, it's just a size issue. That's probably what Oklahoma State should do. Put Martin in that little pinch post area, let her turn around and shoot. If you put her on the block, it allows the Bonnies to double team.
16 points, 10 rebounds now. Maycock drives, rejected over the top by Lecker, a junior from Kansas. A big possession here for Oklahoma State. Coleman off balance, doesn't get it to go. And was that the shot that they wanted?
I'm not mad at that shot. I'm not mad because it was a pretty clean look. I think it's makeable, and they were able to get it before the Bonnies realized what was happening and couldn't help out.
Jumping in the lane and drawing contact is Reeder.
But to your point, why not go back to Martin? You just kind of saw where she might be successful against this defense. Why not milk that?
Rodrika Patton has picked up the foul. That's her first. Fourth on the Cowgirls. Minute 49 seconds to go here in the third quarter. 43-36 St. Bonaventure.
Haven't heard Healy's name much recently.
There she is. Amani Outlaw. Back it out. One of the more patient possessions we've seen from St. Bonaventure today. And it's going to not bear any fruit. Turnover. Off the steal. Patton couldn't finish. And she's fouled. Very late whistle.
St. Bonaventure foul.
It's going to go against Emily Michael.
That might have been one of those, let's see if this goes in before I call the foul. But great job by Patton to get that passing lane. She didn't get the finish, but she got the foul.
Shooting two.
So Rodrika Patton will go to the line for two. In Palestine, Texas, the senior misses the front end. Not a very good foul shooter at 57%.
Oklahoma State has really struggled from the foul line today.
Yeah.
You know,
with the exception of Martin.
Right. Depending on how this game goes, they can look back at that number, 11 for 20 right now, and feel very disappointed in it.
She gets one of two, 43-37, a minute 20 to go, third quarter. Michael to Reeder. Halfway down, came out. Rebound, tracked down by Britt Barr, and there's a foul. That's on Lecker.
Oklahoma State foul number 45.
Third on Caitlin Lecker.
Not a great foul here by Lecker. It's a loose ball. She's trying to grab it. Completely got her arm. But if you're, you know, a heads-up player, and you know you're, God, almost 90 feet away from your own basket, why are you fouling? Your team's in the bonus.
Yep.
Don't
Both teams are. Yep. The
yeah.
rest of the quarter.
You got to be aware of that. That's a poor foul.
Got them both. Only attempted one free throw this year before those two makes. And they're big ones. Makes it an 8-point lead for St. Bonaventure. All right, she got the roll.
Muscled that one in.
Yeah, Brittany Martin with two more. She's now got 18.
Good job by Oklahoma State. Get Martin in that little sweet spot. There it was a little bit closer to the baseline, but she's got the size advantage. She can literally just turn and shoot.
She had a cool start to her day, but she started to heat up. And another whistle and another turnover, this time a traveling call against the Bonnies.
What you're going to see here from Martin is making a quick move. And what that does is, you know, kind of disable the Bonnie defense. It doesn't allow them to help as much. Seems like Martin is slowly figuring out what to do.
And Martin in that double team fouled again. So she'll head to the line with 21 seconds to go in the quarter.
Oklahoma State foul.
We have seen hardly any Kaylee Jensen here in the second half. The sophomore post for Oklahoma State.
It's been a good adjustment by Coach Littell to leave Jensen out of the game. I'm sure she's not happy about it, but when your team's having success without you, you know, sometimes that just happens the way mismatches go. But for Brittany Martin, it's been about getting her the ball in the situations where she's not necessarily at the block posting up, but in situations where she can make quick moves, she can shoot over players close enough to do so. They've done a good job of getting her in those spots.
So you think it's more the adjustment that Littell has decided to make than it is that she's got three persons?
Probably. Because yeah. You saw him do it early in the game, and there was no foul trouble then.
Right. So the one free throw makes it a 45-40 lead. 10 seconds to go. St. Bonaventure can take the last shot of the quarter. They can hang on to it. They won't. Coleman takes it away. 2 seconds to go. Martin's got to hurry. Won't get a shot off. And we're going to the fourth quarter in a 5-point game between the 10 seed and the 7 seed. St. Bonaventure looking for the upset. Winner moves on to play Oregon State Sunbear. Play Matvick at Sue Bird back here in Corvallis, Oregon. The NCAA Women's Championship presented by Capital One. First round coverage. The 10 seed, St. Bonaventure, leading by 5 over the 7 seed, Oklahoma State, as we get ready to start the fourth quarter. Oklahoma State has been taken out of its comfort zone throughout this game. With that said, the star players have really done their part. Martin with 19 for Oklahoma State. Katie Healy, 16 points for St. Bonaventure.
Those two have been the story. And, you know, as of late, really in that third quarter, it's been more Martin. Yeah. You haven't really talked about Healy. She hasn't really done much scoring.
St. Bonaventure, second trip to the NCAA tournament. Made it to the Sweet 16 in their first trip, only trip. Can they surprise again? Cowgirls with the ball. This is Martin spinning away from Healy, or trying to. Now hemmed in on that sideline. And she got it in somehow. That was a tough angle.
She had to make that one up. And what I find most interesting is that Coach Crowley put Healy on Martin. Martin was killing the guards, just shooting right over them.
Rough answers back on the other end. That's her first basket of this game, but it's a big one. Lead back to 5.
Again, we see Healy matched up on Martin. Martin finds a way, though. Let's see what happens now.
Healy, great defense. Timeout. Nope, they're going to call a 3-second violation. Jim Littell is saying he was granted the timeout.
You can see the determination by Brittany Martin. She's trying to put this game on her shoulders.
Nope.
She wasn't even going to pass that ball.
Lead official overruling. And that's a 3-second violation. Turnover, Cowgirls. And Jim Littell just crosses his arms and says, well, maybe I'll get him next time. 9 minutes to go. Every possession's so big now, too, Sue.
Absolutely. Got to take care of the ball. Got to get good shots on goal every possession.
Miranda Drummond gets it back in the hands of Mariah Ruff. 5 to shoot. Ruff pulls up. Quickly in transition, Patton. Great name for a floor general, huh? Enrica Patton. They go inside. Coleman kicks it back out. Patton had a look at a 3, decides to penetrate. Walton now, long 3. No. And a rebound, tracked down by Mariah Ruff. Ruff has assists in almost 30% of this team's baskets this year. Is this another one? No. As Rombach couldn't hit, Kelsey Rombach, the senior shooter off the bench, ahead. Walton able to finish for Oklahoma State. And just like that, the Cowgirls within 3.
That was one of those scenarios I was trying to get at earlier. When they have numbers, they need to push. That's really, you know, one of the few times you've seen them score in transition. I think they should have gone to that earlier. Try to.
Rombach dumps it inside. Healy going to work on Martin. Nice spin to get some separation, and she drops it in.
Great move. Her coach kind of described her as being Jack Sikmalik, which as a Seattle Storm / RIP Sonics, very familiar with his footwork.
Turnover. Big possession for the Bonnies. Drummond smartly pulls it out.
Very smart. That could have been disastrous if she had gone for it.
Lead is 5. The Bonnies have led by as many as 11 in this game as they try to get the upset. There's a steal. Quick hands by Brittany Martin. They've got numbers. 3-on-1. Walton. Oh, she was in too deep. Didn't have a good angle. And a jump ball. Possession arrow favors St. Bonaventure. All right, here's that Jack Sikmalik you were talking about.
I hope people know who that is. She's just able to keep her balance, keep her pivot foot down, and read what Martin. Now, Martin played good D here. She cut her off, and then, boop, gave that little reverse pivot and hit the jumper.
Healing out with 18 on 8 of 12. She's posting up again. Boy, she went right around Martin, drew the foul, and won.
Big time move by Healy. And that's Martin's fault. She went for the steal. She went for that steal. And that gave Katie Healy just enough time and space to take that thing right to the rack. You can't see it on that replay, but the minute Martin put herself out of position, Katie Healy was going to the bucket.
How many times did Jim Crowley talk about a great first step yesterday? We saw it again there. It's the three-point play. It's her 7th 20-point game this season. 52-44, the lead back to 8 for the Bonnies. Now Martin dribbled it off her own foot, out of bounds, unforced error, and the Bonnies get it back.
And I think now you're actually starting to see the Healy on Martin matchup payoff for the Bonnies. Martin can't just turn and shoot. So that time she tried to rip through and drive. Bonnies had some help there for Healy, caused the turnover.
Drummond, 3. That bench would have exploded if she had made that. Martin, through traffic, gets it into the front court for Oklahoma State. They need a big possession here. And was that an ill-advised hurried shot?
I think so. Now, if you tell me that's a 50% three-point shooter who gets a good look, I'm all about that, but that's not really Patton's shot.
No, she's 27% from out there. Healy again. This has been fun to watch this battle this quarter. Healy's been winning it, too, and she'll go to the line. Martin picking up the foul.
I love that when she squares up, depending on who's guarding her, she's just sizing him up. She's looking at him dead in the eye and thinking, all right, where's my advantage? On some of those slower posts, she was able to go right by him. On some of the shorter players, she was able to shoot over them. With Martin, it's been a mixture, but she's really taken advantage of it.
Very efficient game for Healy. Later tonight, after the NCAA Wrestling Championships on ESPN, SportsCenter at night with Nicole and Stan. They're going to have highlights of the NCAA men's and women's tournaments, the NIT, spring training, NBA, NHL. You got it covered on SportsCenter at night. The lead is 10 for St. Bonaventure.
Oklahoma State has their work cut out. Five and a half minutes to go. Jensen has now checked back in the game. See how that affects things.
Can she make a difference now? No points in this ball game. She averages 15. She's trying to post up now. Working around Healy. Didn't get the shot to go, but she will find herself on the stripe.
Yeah, this is a player that's usually very good at finishing those potential three-point plays. On the year, she's had 26 and ones, converted on 19 of them. Today, we've seen a couple. She hasn't finished them off with the free throw, though. And here she'll get 2, but again, usually she's finishing those shots. We haven't seen that.
0 for 4 at the line in this ballgame. She gets her first. And she's playing with 3 personal fouls the remainder of this game. Healy comes out to get a breather. What a day it's been for her.
Finally got a breather, right?
Got both. Big makes for Kaylee Jensen. Sophomore from Genoa, Nebraska. An hour west of Omaha. 5 minutes to go. St. Bonaventure leading 54-46. The 10 seed trying to pull an upset here in round one. Ruff, fancy dribbling. Now Michael with eight to shoot. Ran into a double team. Jensen knocked her down. No whistle. Here comes Walton for the Cowgirls. Coleman for three. And Michael just willed her way to the rebound, and she just took it away from Coleman.
I think that's what Michael's role here is. She's actually a very good defensive player and usually guards other teams' best players, her along with Ruff. And, you know, what we've seen is she just does a little bit of everything for this team.
Here's Reeder. Well, Reeder can't hit the three-point shot. She's hit three in this game. Didn't get that one. And that goes in for Walton. Her third three, she's in double figures. That Oklahoma State bench showing life here. Down five again with 4 minutes even to play. Five on the shot clock, Ruff. Drummond, no. Michael again, scrappy on the floor. Timeout, St. Bonaventure. Boy, you can give that possession to Drummond. Bonnie's lead by five, 3:36 to go in Corvallis.
The NCAA Women's Championship is presented by the Quicksilver Card from Capital One. Earn unlimited 1.5% cash back every purchase, every day. And in part by the newly redesigned Volkswagen Passat, where family happens.
Clay Matrick alongside former UConn star Sue Bird, also a three-time Olympic gold medalist. Longtime WNBA star. It's your 15th year in the league?
Something like that.
Wow.
Stop aging me.
Congratulations on a great career. It's been a pleasure to work with you here.
Thank you, thank you.
In the Women's NCAA Tournament, where St. Bonaventure has a lead here with 3:36 to go. It's crunch time now. Cowgirls of Oklahoma State in jeopardy of being upset here by the Bonnies, who have run a great game plan.
They have. And offensively, they've actually gone to this matchup right here between Ruff and Patton and let Ruff just create, go one-on-one and create for her teammates.
Katie Healy, the skip pass into the corner. Michael for three. Got it! Big basket for Emily Michael.
That's the same play we saw earlier in this game. The Bonnies move the ball, and Michael's being guarded by Jensen, which is Littell's response to Healy. And it's causing open jumpers for Michael, and she hits again.
It's only the third shot she's attempted today. She's made two threes. Talk about efficiency. Big possession for the Cowgirls. This is Jensen again, defended well, but they're going to call Healy for her fourth personal foul.
So the Bonnies have really, throughout this entire game, just taken what the defense has given. And Michael, you can see her on the opposite side of the floor. Jensen is the player that's guarding her. And as the play continues, Healy just sees the open player opposite. Boom, Michael hits a huge three.
Timeout on the floor, back in a moment. St. Bonaventure leads by eight with 2:44 to go, but Healy just picked up her fourth foul.
Yeah, just a situation where that, you know, non-shooting arm is what she hit, and then that little lean in at the end, even though she got all ball, anytime a post player, especially in the post, but anytime a post player has their hands straight up but then leans in or moves them away from that upright position, refs have to call it.
Kaylee Jensen for Oklahoma State at the line, misses the first of two. There's now 2 of 5 at the stripe. There's Healy. Three points for Healy.
I doubt she's out for long. All this really tells me is that Coach Crowley trusts his team. You know, obviously Healy's been the go-to player and the one producing, but he trusts the rest of his team. But I can't imagine she's on the bench for long.
A foul against Amazi, her first.
Diana Monty. That's her first, 13.
And 13 foul on the Cowgirls. Two team fouls in the bodies. Ruff triggers it in. She'll get it back. Trying to trap her. She gets away from it. Michael now. Ruff spins away. Takes it in. What an attack.
Great attack.
Mariah Ruff with her fourth point.
The best way to beat a zone is once you get past that first line of defense, you continue to attack. Some teams don't do that.
The lead back to nine for St. Bonaventure. It is go time now for the Cowgirls. Amazi, bad shot.
Not who they want shooting in that possession.
Two more. Drummond. She was left all alone behind the defense.
Wide open again. That's just attacking a press, beating the first line, and continuing to attack.
And they're doing this without Healy. Turnover. Taken away by Drummond.
St. Bonaventure has done a great job of taking care of this press. I mean, the seed just parted on that one for Ruff, but more than anything, they're just finding their teammates. I don't think Oklahoma State's necessarily a pressing team, and you could tell. They left players open. They didn't pick up the ball.
I thought there was a foul on Andy Coleman, but apparently not. Did they give that foul to Coleman?
Oklahoma State foul number 10.
Yes, they did. So now Sydney Walton with a foul. That's her first, and now the 15 foul against Oklahoma State. So Nyla Reeder goes to the free throw line here for St. Bonaventure, leading by 11 with a minute 37 to go.
If this plays out the way it's looking to play out, she's making her free throws. Those two possessions where Oklahoma State pressed and gave up two layups. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's hard to say there's a turning point with a minute and a half, but that was the turning point. They were within reach and then gave up four quick points.
Oklahoma State only a couple of minutes ago crept to within three. And they had an opportunity with Healy on the bench. And they give it away as Martin couldn't corral it. Healy back in the game now for the Bonnies with just over a minute to go. That was the 17th turnover for Oklahoma State. And now a foul there on Coleman.
With Healy, you know, picking up that fourth foul and going to the bench, really all that did was create a situation for Oklahoma State where St. Bonaventure was going to have a hard time scoring. That's pretty much been the case. The offense has gone through Healy every single possession. But then by pressing and giving up those layups, they never allowed that to play out.
14-point lead for St. Bonaventure. Reeder has another foul shot coming. And St. Bonaventure, just the second time in the national tournament.
They've never lost in the first round.
And they've never lost in the first round. Doesn't appear that that's going to happen in this one, no. So it's looking like it's Oregon State, St. Bonaventure, a 2-versus-10 matchup on Sunday. That is Coleman scoring for the Cowgirls, and Jim Littell calls the timeout with 56 seconds left. Capital One Cup Impact Performance, Katie Healy, the senior from Lancaster, New York. They list her at 6'1". We think that's...
That might be trickery right
there.
Yeah,
that's trickery. She's really closer to 6'3". She played big today, too.
Yeah, maybe they just want people to underestimate her because she's the type of player that can really beat you in a lot of ways. And it's rare to see a player who doesn't shoot threes do what she does offensively and score the points that she scores at her size. You know, she's kind of slim, but has that first quick step. And she just played great tonight.
She averages 15, 23 in this game. Very efficient, 9 of 13 from the field. Three rebounds, a couple of assists as well. Capital One Cup Impact Performance. St. Bonaventure made it to the Sweet 16 in 2012. Maybe they're a team of that kind of destiny this year. Certainly they gave matchup problems to the Cowgirls right from the get-go in this one, and maybe they'll be that kind of a problem for the team they meet next.
Well, Jim Crowley, you know, jokingly said they're not going to win the layup line, right? Talking about his team, and you know, looks can be deceiving, and I think teams tend to underestimate these Bonnies, and they tend to think, you know, they're going to be able to steamroll them physically, but that's not the case at all. And assuming they pull this one off, which it looks like it, they're going to be going against a tougher Oregon State team that hasn't gotten out of the second round.
13-point lead, 50 seconds to go. Missed by Lecker. It's going to stay with Oklahoma State here, 46 seconds to go. There is the Oregon State head coach. Coach Rusick very pleased with his team's performance today. I mean, from the start, Troy didn't have a chance.
No, they didn't. And a lot of that had to do with Hamblin's play. And that's a, you know, 6'5", 6'6", player. How will the Bonnies handle that?
Although watching St. Bonaventure today, I'm sure he's figuring our team has its work cut out.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Again, I think part of St. Bonaventure's advantage is people taking them lightly. You know, looking at them and not seeing much size, not seeing much athleticism, but they play very well together. They have their system. They pack it in. And they're very efficient offensively. It sounds much like Oregon State, to be honest.
Yeah.
Very similar.
Well, the career of Brittany Martin is going to come to an end, barring a miraculous comeback here by the Cowgirls in the last 45 seconds. The senior from Syracuse, Utah, the first ever player out of the state of Utah that ended up at Oklahoma State to play women's basketball. She was recruited by the late Kurt Budke, decided to stay after his death, and the people in Stillwater have loved watching her play the last 4 years.
Yeah, she really has developed into not only the face of the program, but really their best player, their go-to player. You know, to be player of the year, defensive player of the year, it says a lot about the talent that you have. And unfortunately for her, it seems like her career is going to be over, but she's going to continue playing for sure. She's going to be a good pro.
The draft is next month in the WNBA. Brittany Martin will hear her name called. Cowgirls not fouling. St. Bonaventure. Every time they get into this thing, now granted, it's a short list, but they make noise.
They do. So well coached. It's really been impressive to watch them.
Jim Crowley's Bonnies of St. Bonaventure, the 10 seed, moving on as they take down the 7 seed Oklahoma State, 65-54. They have a date on Sunday with the Beavers of Oregon State, the 2 seed.
They do, but for now, they should just enjoy this win.
Here's a look at the bracket. DePaul and Louisville with wins today. St. Bonaventure and Oregon State winning here in Corvallis. And Healy with a terrific game, 23 points to lead the Bonnies. 65-54, the final. We now send it to the studio and Kevin Nagandi.
Clay, thank you so much here in studio. Kevin Nagandi, Kara Lawson, and Rebecca Lobo. So St. Bonaventure, this is the second time they've been in the tournament. And then 4 years ago, you saw them in the Sweet 16 losing to Notre Dame, but then they get the win here. We're talking about a team that was on the bubble Monday, and now they're advancing to round number two.
Well, first of all, they played great scouting report defense. You know, they knew how to double down inside. They knew which players to help off of on the perimeter. And then offensively, when you shoot 50%, you have a great chance to beat any opponent. And Katie Healy was outstanding for St. Bonaventure, but they work the ball around. This is a system kind of offense where they're going to look for dribble penetration. They're going to find open shooters. They're not afraid to run the shot clock down. And we've seen throughout the course of today, teams that come in, play to their identity, play to their game plan, give themselves a good chance to win.
Yeah, the execution to me was impressive. And really, when Oklahoma State made a run there in the second half to still maintain what you do, maintain your identity, continue to execute, knocking down shots certainly helped. I was really impressed with Katie Healy and her performance. I mean, just her presence, her ability to finish shots. Watch out, Oregon State.
All right.
Here comes Bonna.
And you mentioned Healy. She had 23 points. We'll see if she can carry that in a couple days against an Oregon State team that really made a statement when they were on their home floor. Speaking of being on their home floor.